Okay, the next thing we're going to talk about is trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis, I think one thing we have to understand is one infected animal in a herd makes an infected herd. Okay, trichomoniasis is a venereally transmitted disease. So I want to stress that again. The only way that disease is passed is through the breeding act. And that's the only way it's passed. So you've got to have an infected cow to infect the bull or an infected bull to infect the cow. So remember that as we go through. If an animal, and I continually get asked this question, okay, Tom, what if I had trich 2 years ago and some bull calves and I wanted to keep one of those calves for a bull, would he have trich? No, the only way he's going to become infected is through the breeding act. Once he matures, if he bred an infected cow, but he won't carry that protozoa through gestation and then be infected later on. So a little bit about the disease. When bulls get the disease, they never clear the disease. Now again, I'm talking a little bit in generalities. We know that younger bulls tend to probably don't get the, they tend to be a little bit more resistant to get infected, okay? But once a bull becomes infected, then he never clears. He's infected. Now we have to be cautious here because we say, okay, I had a bull and he was infected, and this was before the laws changed, and I rechecked him 2 months later and he wasn't infected. We had a trial right here on campus a few years ago. We had some bulls here for nearly 2 years. And we tested those bulls real frequent because that was one of the factors we were trying to look at. Some of those bulls would be positive and then negative for several months and then become positive again. And these bulls were not being reinfected because they were all without females behind the high fence. So again, understand that this is not as an exact disease as we would like to think about, right? But just use the concept, if that bull's infected, then he's probably gonna stay, well, he is, for practical purposes, gonna be infected for life, okay? Now let's talk a little bit about the cow. The difference between the cow and the bull is the cows do develop some immunity, and they'll develop antibodies. They're hard to measure in the blood, but you can measure them actually in the uterus and sometimes in the vaginal tissue. But they're a little more difficult to measure in the blood, but they will develop some antibodies and they will clear the infection, but that immunity is not cleared for very long, maximum of about 15 months. So what happens to these cows is they'll get infected, but when they get infected, they'll usually go ahead and conceive, and we're going to talk about that in a minute as to how the process plays out. But they'll conceive, a lot of times dump, rebreed again. So again, cows do have some immunity, but it's short immunity. Okay, now it's a chronic disease. Once that disease becomes chronic, because you hear all the horror stories, well, trich causes, if you get trich, you only get 30% of your calves. You lose 60% of your calves, this disease. When it initially affects the herd, and initially the first year or two, that can certainly happen if it's never been there before. But I can tell you that I've seen this disease chronic in a lot of herds. All diseases start to kind of seek a level in a herd. Trich's probably the worst one. So if it stays in there and you're leaving your bulls out all year round, and you'll understand this better as we talk about it, you might have the disease and not even know it, and it's still costing you a lot of money. Okay, so management for trich is test your bulls. Now again, that's the law in Texas now. Regulations say anytime a bull changes hands, it has to be tested. So if I borrow a bull from you, if I buy a bull from you, if I lease a bull from you, anytime that bull changes hands, by law, it must be tested, right? Manage your cows. Currently, regulations do not affect the cow. Where did we say the bulls got the infection? From the cow. So understand that cows, even though they do clear up after a while, there's still a risk. And some cows, about a half of 1%, can stay chronically infected through gestation, so they cause more of a risk. Okay, there is a vaccine product out there. So I'm not here to promote or to condemn the vaccine. I'm just going to say, if you use the vaccine, tie it with management. If you use the vaccine by itself, no, you're not going to see a terrible lot of results unless you use that vaccine properly and tie other management protocols with it. Again, in practice, I would get into that all the time. You'd think, well, I've really suspicion trick is a problem with your reproduction. And no, doc, it couldn't be because I'm vaccinating. They were applying the vaccine at the wrong time. And the vaccine is not particularly, in fact, it is not labeled for prevention. It's labeled more for control of the disease. Okay, where the organism lives, and so in the male, it lives on the penis. So basically, this organism does not invade the tissue, it adheres. It kind of sticks to the outside of the tissue. And it likes to live in what's called a microaerophilant, or an environment, it's not totally absent from oxygen, but you have a decreased level of oxygen there. So that's where the organism likes to grow. So that's where it stays in the male. Okay, so I'm going to use the gestation slide again like we used in BVD. So again, we're going out there about 283 days. What happens to you is most of these cows, like we said a while ago, even if they're infected by a bull, they will go ahead and conceive most of the time. Now, traditionally, we've said out there about 60 days is when most of these cows will go ahead and abort. They'll abort, and then they clean up because, like I said, they develop immunity. So not all of them, but the majority of these cows will develop some immunity, and usually in about a stress, this is not exact, 2 estrous cycles, 40 days, 50 days, they will be clean enough to rebreed. Okay, so what would I see in my herd where I had trick? You'd see a lot of open cows, for one thing, but you'd see a lot of calves that your calf crop would be spread out. In other words, a lot of these cows would have bred, dumped, and rebreed. So you'd have a lot more spread in your calf crop. So if you got your bulls turned out for 60 days, 70 days, even up to 90 days, then you're going to see a big impact of trick, because these cows that abort do not have time to rebreed. If you've got your bulls turned out for longer periods of time, then what you're going to see is you're going to see more pregnant cows, but more spread out cows. So one of the tip-offs when you're getting into a trick herd is as you're palpating these cows, you'll have a few more open cows, and I'm talking about chronic trick now that's been there a few years. You'll have a few more open cows, but you'll be going along and you'll have six-month bred, uh-oh, here's two months, 6 months, see, because they're more spread out. You would hope that those cows, about 60% of cows in an efficient operation, are going to breed in the first estrus, 60% of those left over in the next estrus, et cetera, and so you're losing all that efficiency. Okay, so basically what happens is, and pretty much most of the stuff you're going to read is got this focusing on that 60, 70 days where our big loss is. There's a couple of papers in the literature, one particularly out of Wyoming, where that they found about a third of all the loss was in the last third of gestation. We've done some trials and stuff looking at products here in Texas, looking at developing diagnostic tests, actually improving on diagnostic tests. And what we found there is we found what we thought was a bigger proportion of these cows that were having late-term abortions. Again, this is not a randomized controlled trial. This is only kind of an observational, kind of what we observed over a two-year period of time. But what I am saying is cows can abort from trick later on in the cycle, okay? So again, you have to keep that in mind. So just if you're seeing some late abortions and you're saying this couldn't be trick, well, it could still potentially be trick. Okay, so again, horror stories. Everybody talks about, well, if you got trick, you've got about 30% conception, right? And so if you're better than that, you don't have trick. Again, once that disease is there, it kind of starts to seek its level. Train wrecks. And the biggest train wrecks you see in well-managed herds. So if a guy's out there and he's really doing a good job and he's got, he picks up his bulls in 90 days or 80 days or whatever, then everything's going good. And then if he gets trick introduced, then all of a sudden his breeding can go to nothing. Disease, again, seeks level over time. Okay, so this is a distribution, what I would expect to see in trick in a herd that's been fairly recently infected with trick. So about 30% of those animals, about 30%, and let's say I'm just talking round numbers, so I got 100 cows up there, right? So about 33 of those cows are just going to go ahead, they're infected, But they can take care of it. Their immune function comes back. They don't abort. So they go in and they deliver a normal calf. So a third of them, and that's where some of this 30% horror stories come from. A third of them will go ahead and deliver a calf. Okay, there's a percentage of them. And again, this is about 8% will go ahead and abort later. Okay, but about, so 20%, well, I'm sorry, the 30% has come, 10% is not infected, and then 20% are infected but don't lose. So you're still going to get about 30% of your calves if you do nothing. Okay, but you're going to get infertility in about 60% of those cattle. Those would be the cattle that got infected, lost their calf, lost the fetus, took a little bit of time to come back and rebreed. All right, so that's kind of the spread of it. Now, a lot of times people talk, if you got trichiorta, see pyometra. Pyometra just means pus in the uterus, right? And so that's one of the things, and that's cool. And years ago, that everything was stressed on that. That's going to be for only 2 to 5% of the cases. So if you're going out and you're trying to, and you go through a bunch of cows and you don't find pyometra, or you don't see pus coming out of your cows, and somebody says, well, it couldn't be that. It couldn't be trick because you have to have pus. Very small percentage of your deals, of your cases. So again, understand trichomoniasis. Again, it's kind of like the iceberg. You don't see much until all of a sudden you don't have calves, or you've got some, the calves you have are spread out. Currently we test the bulls for trichomoniasis, and how we test them is real simple. Is we take an insemination pipette, a mare like you'd breed a mare with, or and then you just take and you take that, put it in the prepuce, and you scrape, because what we say, that organism's adhered to the outside of the tissue, and you scrape that, applying suction, you get that organism up into the pipette, and then you put it, and that's showing what a sample would look like, and then you put that sample. Currently, by law, we use a little, we put it in a little, it's called an impouch, a little plastic pouch with growth media. Send it to the lab as soon as possible.